All right, shalom, shalom. First off, give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Makar Kadash. Give honors to the apostles and the elders of GMS. Salutes and honors to the elect, all the brothers across the four corners who are enduring in truth and sincerity, all the men and the women who follow. So this lesson is going to be entitled somewhere along the lines of Every Knee Shall Bow. All right, and this is speaking of our Lord, Yahweh Shai. All right, obviously the scripture is Philippians chapter 2 and verse 10. It says, I started at verse 9. It says, wherefore the Most High also have highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that the name of Yahweh Shai, at the name of Yahweh Shai, every knee shall bow of things in heaven and things of earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Yahweh Shai HaMashiach is Lord to the glory of the Most High the Father. All right, so when it says every knee shall bow, that's speaking of everyone. All right, everyone is going to give their supplication. Everyone is going to submit to the glory, the power, the honor, all the above, okay, for our Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. All right. So I just wanted to get into the aspect of bowing the knee, how, you know, every knee shall bow, because, well, let's get into the actual act of it. All right, so what's the origin of bending the knee? All right, it's the custom of genuflecting. All right, what's that word, genuflecting? To genuflect is to lower one's body briefly by bending one knee to the ground, typically in worship or as a sign of respect. Okay, so when you bend the knee, or when you genuflect, all right, you're showing worship. You're showing a sign of respect and supplication, in this case, to Yahweh Shai. You're saying that it's not you, it's not your will that's going to be done, but I'm following your lead. Okay? It says the custom of genuflecting as a sign of respect and even of service arose out of the honor given to medieval kings. In modern times, when a folded flag of fallen veterans is offered to the family, the presenting officer will go down on his left knee and the recipient is seated. All right, now, this didn't just come from medieval times. Although I'm going to give a good example in a video right here, I have a even earlier example with Joseph, okay? So, this is Genesis 41 and 41. It says, "And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, See, I have set thee over all the land of Egypt. And Pharaoh took off his ring from his hand and put it on Joseph's hand and arrayed him in vestures of fine linen and put a gold chain about his neck. And he made him to ride in the second chariot which he had, and they cried before him, Bow the knee, and he made him ruler over all the land of Egypt. And Pharaoh said unto Joseph, I am Pharaoh, and without thee shall no man lift up his hand or foot in all the land of Egypt. So basically, he put Joseph in charge of Egypt, and he told everyone to do what? To bow their knee, to give a sign of respect unto Joseph, okay? To let everyone know, hey, he's running this joint, okay? And that's what everyone is going to do in the time that Yahweh Shai comes back and take over this place, okay? So one thing I want to speak about is the moral decay that's been going on, okay? Back in the olden days, you guess you'll say, you know, in the time of Joseph, in the time of these medieval kings, people had some act right. You know, people knew they had respect. It's right there in the word genuflecting. They had respect. Okay? Let's get that word respect. All right, respect, it says late 14th century, a relationship, relation, regard, consideration, respect, old French respect, from Latin respectus, to regard, looking at, literally, the act of looking back, all right? Looking back at what? Looking back at someone's actions and exalting it, you know, regarding it, considering it, from read, back, and spire, to look at, so to look back. To observe someone's actions and to basically give them praise, give praise to them. But what's the word I'm looking for? Let me see. Let's go to the definition because maybe that'll give me some. It says a deep feeling of admiration. There you go. So you're looking back and you're giving someone that admiration, all right, for someone or something elicited by their abilities, qualities, or achievements. Okay, so you're looking at the abilities, their qualities, everything that they've done, and you're giving them admiration for it. Let's get admiration then. Admiration, the noun says from early 15th century, wonder, admiration, astonishment, surprise, directly from Latin. Admiratorium, a wondering and admiration, to be astonished with regard. High regard, high esteem. Right. You're admiring them, okay? So respecting someone is in giving them high regard and admiring them, okay? So let me see. Going back into the moral decay, okay? And of course, we're in Babylon. So I'll get the scripture. This is Proverbs 14:34. It says, righteousness exalteth a nation, but sin is a reproach to any people. And in here in the valley of the shadow of death, right? Where they say, do as thou wilt, where the Bible is not, the Bible is looked at as fiction, science fiction at that, all right? Angels and miracles, walking on water, you know, the bulk of the people don't believe. And the people that so-called do believe or say they believe aren't following it the right and correct way. All right, we'll get into that here in a little bit. But the moral decay, if the Lord came back, half the people wouldn't even know to bend the knee and to put that respect on our Lord's name. All right, so let's get an example of when people did know. Because matter of fact, let me get this one first. So this is from Game of Thrones when the king is arriving. So notice that's respect right there. The king is arriving, okay? You see his train, all his company, okay? And everyone's standing. Everyone's there ready to greet the king, okay? That's respect. These people in what I'm trying to get at, because I know this is a show, it's a movie, or it's a television show, but art imitates life, okay? This is showing that people in previous times had more respect. All right. their morality was maybe not where at 100%, but it was a hell of a lot higher than what it is today. I know I'm talking a lot, but I just need to make a point. Like, you couldn't make a meme about the king in those days, you know? Like, Trump is so many memes about Trump. Sleepy Joe, you know? You couldn't talk about the rulers like that. You know, they'd have your head. All right? We live in a time where, you know, people, mostly Americans, believe they got so much freedom, and so you can, like I said, do as thou wilt. People think that they can come and go as they please, and they don't have to adhere to a higher power. But when our Lord Yahweh Bashem Yahshai comes back, okay, when Yahweh Shai comes back, all right, he's not going to meet you as a man, and you're going to bow that knee. All right, we're going to get into that.
Sansa, where's your sister?
Hey. What are you doing with that, son? Go on.
Move.
Bows the knee. Everyone gives respect when it's due. They automatically knew what to do. Came over with tools to help and bowed the knee. Look at them. That's respect. And then everybody else raises up. He tells you to raise up. That's when you can get up. Okay? And like I said, Yahweh Shai, when he comes back, he's not going to meet, okay, this world as a man. All right? He's coming back for fire, for revenge. Okay? He said that he's going to... Man, fuck, let's get that. Let me see which one... Hold on. Here we go. This is Revelation 1 and 7. It says, "Behold, he cometh with clouds, and every eye shall see him, and they also which pierced him, and all kindreds of the earth." It's like, "And all kindreds of the earth shall wail because of him, even so amen." So when the Lord comes back, everyone's going to know that it's that time. All right? And, hey, the Lord's going to get revenge. This is also proves reincarnation, because the ones who pierced him are the Roman soldiers. That was more than 2,000 years ago. So they're going to be back. They're back in these times. So, hey, the Lord's coming back with blood. All right, he's coming back for blood. All right, let's get this video. I'm playing this because there's two ways that people are going to bow the knee. Either, you know, out of respect or out of fear. All right? And like I said, the Lord's coming back with a vengeance. All right? So that fear. This is how you make somebody bow with fear.
I know what Cersei has told you. That I've come to destroy your cities, burn down your homes, murder you and orphan your children. That's Cersei Lannister, not me. I'm not here to murder. And all I want to destroy is the wheel that has rolled over rich and poor to the benefit of no one but the Cersei Lannisters of the world. I offer you a choice. Bend the knee and join me. Together, we will leave the world a better place than we found it. Or refuse. And die.
That's what fear do. Fear will make men to bow that knee. Okay? So, where it says that at the name of Yahawashi, every knee shall bow of things in heaven and things of earth and things under the earth. Whether it's by fear, whether it's by respect, they're going to bow that knee. All right? You can bet your bottom dollar on that. All right? Like I said, man, these times people don't have the moral compass that they should. All right, and it says 2 Timothy 3:1, it says, this know also that in the last days perilous times shall come, for men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasures more than lovers of the Most High, having a form of godliness but denying the power thereof, from such turn away. And that's what I was speaking about earlier, because you have people, all right, who claim that they know the scriptures, or you have people that maybe go to church every Sunday. All right. Claim they caught the Holy Spirit or the Holy Ghost. Did a little dance and a shout. And blah, 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 blah. You know, claim they spoke in tongues. Having a form of godliness, but denying the power thereof. Because they're, at the end of the day, you're worshiping white Jesus. You're not calling on the name of Yahweh by Shem Yahashai. All right, you calling on Jesus Christ. You're saying that you're saved already. Well, if you're saved already, then what do you need to be saved from in that day? All right, we're all praying to be the hopeful elect. But in these times, people, they got it already. They're entitled. They wouldn't know about it either to the Lord if he came. All right, let's get this last scripture. This is Genesis chapter 6 and verse 5. It says, and the Most High saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. Right? And it repented him, the Lord Yahweh, that he had made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. And the Lord said, I will destroy man whom I have created created from the face of the earth, both man and beast and the creeping thing and the fowls of the air, for it repenteth me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. All right, and we represent Noah, because the Most High had to hit the reset button. He had to destroy everyone. Okay? And save Noah and his family. And that's what's going to happen in these times, but it's not by water. It's going to happen by fire. All right? And the elect are a representation of Noah. So, in order for everyone to bow the knee to correct all of this, you know, depravity, all this, I don't even know the word I want to use. We live in the same world. We know how fucked up Jake is. We know how fucked up this world is. So, hey, man, the fire got to come. And when that fire come, when the chariots come, when Yahweh Shai come, everyone's going to know what's up. Everyone's going to know the name of Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai. Okay? And then what? Then what? All right, this is Isaiah 60:4. It says, lift up thy eyes round about and see. All they gather themselves together, they come to see thee. Thy son shall come from afar. Thy daughter shall be nursed at thy side. Then thou shalt see and flow together. And thine heart shall fear and be enlarged because of the abundance of the sea shall be converted unto thee. The forces of the Gentiles shall come unto thee. All right, so let's get this in the NLT, because it's talking about the heathen bringing the best of the best, all right, unto us, unto starting from the Lord Yahweh Shai on down. It says, your eyes will shine and your heart will thrill with joy. For merchants from around the world will come to you. They will bring you the wealth of many lands. Vast caravans of camels will converge on you, and camels of Midian and Ephah, the people of Sheba, will bring gold. Sakia. I should have started at 4. It says, look and see, for everyone is coming home. Your sons are coming from distant lands. Your little daughters will be carried home. Your eyes will shine, and your heart will thrilled with joy, for the merchants from around the world will come to you. They will bring you the wealth from many lands. So that's going to be respect put on the name of the Lord, respect put on his the Most High's children. All right. And that's when everything was going to be set right and in order. All right. But when the Lord makes his return, all right, whether it be by respect or whether by fear, everyone's going to bend that knee. Everyone's going to bend that knee. And with that being said, Lord, this was edifying. And we give all praise, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rekar Kadash. Double honors to the apostles and the elders of GMS. Salutes and honors to the elect, all the brothers across the four corners who are enduring in truth and sincerity, the men and the women who follow. Hey, Shalom.